early pregnancy loss, or spontaneous abortion, refers to natural termination of a pregnancy before 10 to 13 weeks of gestational age. It is a common occurrence, affecting approximately 10 to 20% of recognized pregnancies. Most of these losses occur in the first trimester, that is, before 12 weeks of pregnancy. The causes of early pregnancy loss are diverse. The most common cause is chromosomal abnormalities, usually due to random errors during fertilization or early embryo development. Conditions like trisomy, monosomy, or translocations are examples. These include uncontrolled diabetes, thyroid disorders, autoimmune diseases such as lupus, and infections including TORCH infections. TORCH is an acronym used to describe a group of infectious diseases that can be transmitted from a mother to her baby during pregnancy, potentially causing congenital infections specifically toxoplasmosis, rubella, cytomegalovirus, and herpes simplex. Congenital uterine defects, uterine fibroids, or an incompetent cervix can interfere with pregnancy viability. Conditions like luteal phase defect or polycystic ovary syndrome may also contribute. Smoking, alcohol use, drug abuse, high caffeine intake, and malnutrition are known risk factors. Exposure to radiation or harmful chemicals such as lead or arsenic can increase the risk. Women over 35 years are at higher risk due to an increased chance of chromosomal issues. The most common symptom is vaginal bleeding. Others include abdominal cramping or pain, the passage of tissue or clots, and a sudden loss of pregnancy-related symptoms such as nausea or breast tenderness. Sometimes, there may be no symptoms at all, and the loss is discovered during an ultrasound. Early pregnancy loss or abortion can be classified into several types. Threatened abortion, where bleeding occurs, but the cervix remains closed. The pregnancy may still continue. Inevitable abortion, where the cervix is open and miscarriage is unavoidable. Incomplete abortion, where some pregnancy tissue is expelled, but some remains in the uterus. Complete abortion, where all pregnancy tissue has been passed. The uterus is empty. In missed abortion, the fetus has died, but there are no immediate symptoms, and the pregnancy remains in the uterus. Septic abortion is an infected miscarriage, often due to retained tissue or unsafe abortion practices. It can be life-threatening. Diagnosis involves several steps. First, a thorough history and physical examination. Then, a transvaginal ultrasound is used to check for fetal heartbeat and assess uterine contents. Blood tests are also important, especially serial beta-hCG levels, which should rise in a healthy pregnancy. A complete blood count and blood type, including Rh status, are usually done. A pelvic exam may also be necessary to assess the cervix and identify any tissue in the vaginal canal. Treatment depends on the type of miscarriage and the woman's clinical condition. There are three main options. Expectant management. This involves waiting for the body to pass the tissue naturally. It's suitable for some cases of incomplete or missed abortion without complications. Medications such as misoprostol, a prostaglandin analog, are used to help the uterus expel its contents. Procedures like dilation and curettage or manual vacuum aspiration are performed to remove remaining tissue, especially in cases of excessive bleeding or infection. In Rh-negative women, anti-D immunoglobulin is administered to prevent Rh sensitization. Antibiotics are necessary if there is any sign of infection or septic abortion. Possible complications of early pregnancy loss include hemorrhage, which may require blood transfusion, infection, particularly if tissue remains in the uterus, Asherman syndrome, where scar tissue forms in the uterus after surgical evacuation, psychological effects such as grief, anxiety, or depression, and finally, recurrent pregnancy loss, defined as two or more consecutive losses, which warrants further evaluation. The outlook is generally positive. Most women who experience an early miscarriage go on to have successful pregnancies in the future. Unless advised otherwise, there is no medical need to delay trying again. However, if a woman has two or more consecutive losses, a detailed medical workup is recommended. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.